Now, I want to talk about you for a little bit. The last time we chatted, we were talking about your property ventures with Valdevi. How's that going?
It's going really, really well. Yeah. And I must say, I just feel so blessed where everything is just falling into place every single time. We've acquired all the land now, and we're busy designing all the new phases. You're planning the bridge across the river. You're planning the schools, the hotel. So for me, it's really, it's a dream come true, and to be able to do what you love. I'm so excited to get to work every day, and I don't really want to leave the estate, because if you miss half a day, you miss some really cool stuff. So it's very exciting.
It must feel like such a sense of accomplishment to see that infrastructure actually going up, the schools and the bridge. Congratulations on that.
Yeah, no, thank you. And you know, like I said, for me, it's always been, you know, like a dream of mine to be able to do that, you know, ever since I was a young boy.
Yeah.
And to be able to live your dream, and as an athlete to have another career, you know, and to be able to do, you know, something that you love again, I feel very blessed to be able to do that.
Wow. Now, on that note, last time we spoke again, you said Chad Leclos is the best swimmer in the world. Do you still think that's true?
I think he is one of the top three. Yeah. I think.
Who are the other two?
I think a guy like at the moment there's the Asian Games happening in Korea, and there's a chap from Japan. His last name is Hagino, and I think he's going to give Chad a big run for his money.
Yeah.
So I think between those two boys, I think they're both. You know, they're both better than Phelps and also Lochte.
Yeah.
I think those boys are not quite on that level. So let's say Chad is one of the top two in the world.
Wow. Now, I did notice that you tweeted about the Japanese swimming team recently. Do you think that they're going to give the other swimmers a run for their money in the next Olympics?
I mean, you can just see on the times, you know. You can see that there will be a big force. The next Olympics in Rio.
Yeah.
But watch out for 2020 in Tokyo. It is just incredible. If you look at the size, I mean, they're very small, but what they're able to do in the water, and that's just because of, you know, their technique and you know, hard work. So I'm a big fan of the Japanese swimmers, and I look forward to the next 6 years and seeing them, you know, just push up and becoming a world superpower in the pool.
Is this something that's been a long time coming? Have you been watching the Japanese team for a while, waiting for this breaking point, or has it caught you by surprise?
I don't think it's really caught me by surprise. I think it's something. I mean, they've always been very hard workers and excellent with technique. I think the last 4 years they've really made a push. And I mean, we see now at the Commonwealth Games what happened with Scotland and the British team, how well they did, because they had the Olympics in 2012 and now the Commonwealth Games. When you have a home games, there's just something about it.
Yeah.
There's more investment in the facilities, in the athletes. And my hope is that, I'm pretty sure we're gonna get the Commonwealth Games in 2022. And my hope is that the same happens here in South Africa, that we can build a legacy, leading hopefully to the Olympics one day, and we can see some, not just one or two good swimmers from South Africa, but a whole group, really taking it on.